Hey, in this crash course, we're going to look at colab quickly and practically. First of all, let's answer this question. What is colab? Colaboratory or colab is a free notebook environment that runs entirely in the cloud. It allows anybody to write and execute Python code through the browser. It means you not have to even install Python in your system, and you can write and execute Python code in any device and anywhere because it runs in the browser. Colab supports many popular packages, including machine learning libraries, which can be easily loaded in your notebook. As I was saying, colab is a notebook environment. What is a notebook? Notebook is a way for us to run code interactively within a web browser alongside some visualization and some markdown text to explain the process of what's going on. First of all, open your browser, go to google.com and search colab. Okay, click on this result, colabresearch.google.com. Also, you can open this URL directly in your browser. Well, to use colab, you need to have a Gmail account. If you haven't, create a Gmail account first and log into your account. Also, colab uses Google Drive for storing your notebooks. So once again, make sure you are logged in to your Gmail account and Google Drive account. After that, colab would display you this screen. Click on New Notebook link at the bottom of the screen. As you can see, I've already created several notebooks. When you click on Create New Notebook, colab will create a new notebook for you. At first glance, this may appear a bit complicated, but it's very simple to work with it, I promise. If you have worked with Jupyter Notebook, this interface is quite similar to the one provided in Jupyter. And if you haven't worked with Jupyter, it doesn't matter. Anyway, the notebook uses the naming convention untitled.ipynb. To rename this notebook, click on this name and type in the desired name you want. For this tutorial, we'll call it as Neon Notebook. Why? Because the name of my website is neonlearn.ir. You can give it any name you want. So type in this name and hit enter. As you can see, the notebook acquires the name that you have given now. In every colab notebook, the most important part is code cell. In one code cell, you can write Python code and then execute it. Let's try. Write print hello colab and click on this icon. Or you can use Control Enter shortcut. Connecting, initializing, and connected. As you can see, your code is executed and the result is displayed below. You can execute as many statements as you want in your code cell. For example, first, I define a variable called sum and set it to 0. Then I create a loop and iterate over a range and set my range from 0 to 10. For r in range 0 to 10. In each iteration, I add I to the variable sum, and after the loop, I print the variable sum. Okay, control enter to run your cell. Your code is executed and the result is displayed below. In each notebook, you can have as many cells as you want. Pay attention. What I want to say is very important. In colab notebook as well as in other notebooks such as Jupyter, after running a cell, if a variable is defined inside that cell, that variable still remains in your RAM. Once again, after running a cell, if a variable is defined inside that variable still remains in RAM. For this very reason, if I create a new cell and then print the variable sum and control enter, you can see that I still have access to my variable sum because I defined the variable sum in previous cell. There is another important point to mention. In notebook, the order is not from top to bottom, but the order is based on execution. For example, I delete these two cells, create two new cells. In first cell, I define a variable called test and set it to a string. Test a string, for example, message. And in second cell, I print the test variable. Now, if I run the second cell, it tells me the test variable is not defined. Why? Because the order is based on execution. The first cell is not executed yet. Now, if I run first cell and then run second cell, it would print the variable test for me. Message. So bear in mind, order is based on execution. Another example. First, I create five cells. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And I wanna to write a print statement in each cell. Okay, I told you order is based on execution. You can run the third cell first, do. Then you may want to run the first cell, then the fourth, then the second. If you have noticed, the order is displayed the left side of each cell. 7, 8, 9, 10. Now I delete these all cells. Colab also provided a space for your files. Remember, your files will be deleted after closing or refreshing your notebook. Let's upload an image to this space and plot it. Click on this icon. Then right click and click on upload. And select an image from your system. Reminder, uploaded files will be get deleted when this runtime is recycled. There is different ways to plot an image. One of them is to use the pillow library. Let's close it. Pillow allows us to work with and manipulate images using Python. I create a new cell. And then from pillow library import image. From PIL import image. You also need no numpy library import numpy as np, and you need matplotlib to plot your image. Import matplotlib.pyplot as plt. If I run that, you can see my script ran with no output. Import. Now I create a new cell again. Then I open my image using open method, which is accessible from image module. This gives me an object, image. This gives me an object that I can work with. I define a new variable called raw and set it to this object. Then I convert this object to a NumPy array. And I run this cell. And I create a new cell again. Next, by using plt.imageShow, I can plot my image. plt.imageShow raw. And I run this cell. As you can see, my image is displayed. You can also put text cells before or after your code cells, wherever you want. To create a new text cell, you can click on here, and inside of it, you can write anything you want. You can also change runtime. Your code is executed on CPU by default. You can change it to GPU. This speeds up the code execution of your codes in many tasks, including metrics, calculations, neural networks, and so on. To change runtime, click on Runtime tab, and then click on Change Runtime Type, and select GPU. And save. And finally, you can save your notebook by pressing Ctrl S. And you can also export from your notebook. For this, go to File tab and click on Download. Go to Download. And download whichever format you want. You can export .ipynb and .py. Well, we're done. Unequivocally, there are many, many other things about colab. But my goal was to get to know colab quickly and practically. Please don't forget to like and subscribe to this YouTube channel. I'll be very happy to see you come back.